Hi, welcome. My name is Ubon King and welcome to the Top 10 Entrepreneur Startup Mistakes. So please, in case you missed the last edition, please click up on this link. Number 7, was not sure you have enough money to start up or to do your business. Number 8, we'll be dealing with spending too much money. You know, everything about business is money. The reason why somebody goes into business is to make profit. And one of the greatest sabotage of business is spending too much money. One categorical reason why people spend too much money is because of their strategic plan. They are in a hurry to get to their destination, so they are doing everything possible to make it there. And people that are strategic, they have a little problem with financing, except they are helped quickly by proper planning and budgeting. So if you have a budget will help control the way you spend money. It will help you plan when to spend the money, how to spend the money. Because like me, when I started my business, I had a challenge with financial, because me, I wanted to get there fast. So anything I could buy for my company, I would buy because I wanted to buy it. But unfortunately, I found that sometimes when you buy something now, you don't need it until the next 2 years. It's not what you need now. What you need now is just to keep moving. Problem there is that avoid spoof spending, avoid spending money you don't need to spend. And that comes with planning, and that comes with budgeting. And it's always good that at this stage in your business, have a good financial planner, a good financial advisor, a good accountant that works with you. Take yourself, if you're an entrepreneur, out of the business. Separate yourself from the money of the business. Let there be strategic meetings between your leadership. Okay, this is what we're going to do, how we're going to do, who is the business process owner, how much do you need, defend the budget. Sometimes if the budget may be 10 million, you may need to start with only 1 million for the next 3 months, so that the company can still stay alive till the next 3 months. You don't just give the 10 million because that's what you have been budgeting for. When do you need it? Identify the critical path. When you need the money, you need the money on the 14th of next month, you need the money on the 20th of 3 months later. So there's a critical path. You understand what you need to do. There's a project plan for every expenditure, because a lot of people, you know, say, okay, you want to buy cars for your company, you buy 10 cars at once. No. You buy according to the cash flow, because if you spend too much, it will eat too much of your business and it will kill you untimely. So avoid it as much as possible. A wise saying says that if you fail to plan, you have already planned to fail. Rather than for you to plan to fail, learn to plan so that you don't fail. Takeaway from here is, you ask yourself, what do I need? Do I really need this asset now? Yes or no? What is the value this asset will bring to my business now? If I don't have this asset, what else can I do to block the gap? What can I have as a temporary measure for it? If I don't get this asset, will it kill my business? What other techniques can I do to get to the next place? Those are the kind of questions you ask yourself as you take away. And once you begin to ask yourself those kind of questions, those kind of ideologies, those kind of things, it helps you to say that yes, this is the path to go. Now, don't follow people because they are going roller coaster. They may be running too fast to fail. The wise man says that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step. And I dare add that it begins with a step in the right direction. If you are going east, if you are taking a step to the west, you are missing it. So you need to ensure that you are moving in a step in the right direction. You are one step away. Keep moving, and that will help you than spending all the money because cash has come to you. Between every two mountains of success, there is a valley of failure. When you climb up a mountain here with cash, and your cash is good, and you are spending, when you get up there, you are going down a valley. If you are not careful, you may not have enough energy, enough steam, enough agility to climb up the second mountain. So be very careful as you are growing in your finances. Get a financial plan, get a financial manager, get a financial controller. Let him tell you, okay, this is where we are going. Sit down and think long term. Stop thinking short term. Think long term, because long term will wait for you in future as a bigger business or as a big failure. That's what is going to happen. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like it, and also, you know, put a comment below, and please share it with your friend who you think will make an impact in them, and let's know what their comments are on it. And I really appreciate you watching this video. Please watch out for the next edition. See you very soon.